Hey yo, what is up YouTube? Gino here today with my review for the new BTS album, Love Yourself Tear. My thoughts on this album? Yeah, it's pretty bloody good. I haven't really loved a BTS project since Wings. I really, really love Wings. It was my favourite album of the year. It's probably my favourite Korean album as of yet. I've obviously only been in this industry for about 3.5 years, but it's Wings has for me stood the test of time. It's a fantastic album. I wasn't so keen on Love Yourself Hurt. I did like it. It came 10th of my list last year, top 10 list. It's a solid album with some really creative songs, but in terms of what I wanted from BTS, it just personally it didn't really fit what I wanted. But you know, that is what it is. That's completely personal opinion. Critically, it really wasn't that bad an album, but I just didn't feel it. This album, my lord, I had pretty high expectations going into it, and they were completely fulfilled. I got a really nice dose of R&B, which I've wanted from BTS for a while. They also brought back some of their hip-hop style from the Dark and Wild days. They had some ideas from Wings as well, some sort of Blood, Sweat, Tears, and you know, the solo V track from Wings, Stigma. I think the intro to this album is sort of the sequel, the better version of that. It's so much more interesting. I love the whole jazzy R&B vibe. His vocals are superb. They're so sort of whispery and breathy, and I love that. He's got such a different voice to the rest of the members, so it works incredibly well when he is a solo song. I enjoyed Stigma a lot, don't get me wrong, but this for me is the best intro track BTS have done. I really like Serendipity, but Singularity here, the V track intro, was I was blown away by it. Something that they did different from Love Yourself Hurt is they experimented more with the sound across the album. A criticism I constantly had of Love Yourself Hurt was that some of the songs they just slowly moved into one another and they didn't really seem that different. Here, I can tell you right now, each song pretty much has a completely different mood, feel, genre, and I absolutely adore that. Going from the intro Singularity into Fake Love, which is this bombastic sort of electronic sounding pop song, it's so utterly bizarre. That chorus hits you so incredibly well. Jimin's vocals are fantastic. I would say that Jin does an incredible job throughout this album, specifically on this song though, on Fake Love. He gets a lot of lines finally during a main title song, and he absolutely nails it. I think it's one of my favourite Jin performances on a song. And Fake Love is actually one of my favourite songs on this album. It's not very often that a title track is my absolute favourite on an album, but I think here pretty much, other than the next song we're going to talk about, I think it may be my favourite song. The next song is The Truth Untold featuring Steve Aoki. There's this gorgeous, gorgeous piano instrumental throughout like three quarters of the song. It's so gorgeous. The vocal line do a great job. And they just it's a beautiful, beautiful sort of ballad piece. But then right at the end, we get this drop and this kick and this energy. And then suddenly they come in with this powerful, powerful vocal section, and it's just so incredible. I really, really enjoyed that. The first time I was listening to it, I was a little bit like, just keep it like the piano, just keep it the piano. But they did it incredibly well, that they kept three quarters of the song piano, and then they launched into this really emotive and passionate section, and it worked incredibly well. And that's something I will talk about a lot during this review, is how passionate this album is. It's probably the best written album BTS have released. The lyrics are incredible, actually, and often the English translations can be a little bit hit and miss. Here, I got a good English translation of this album, and I have to say it's incredibly detailed, and I get a great vibe for this album in terms of this, what they're talking about, and it's incredibly well put together. Probably my favourite album that they've released in terms of what they're talking about. The piano instrumental to The Truth Untold is phenomenal. It's gorgeous. It has a great rhythm to it. It flows so incredibly well. And going from Fake Love, which is a really, really energetic pop song, to this, it's a really nice transition, especially considering what follows on, which makes it four amazing tracks in a row. The next track is, I'm going to have to read it off my phone because I can't remember the numbers. 134340, which are the coordinates for Pluto. And this song is so good. I love the intro. I'm actually just going to play the intro. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha-do-ha I absolutely adore that as an intro. They work in these sort of weird jazzy percussion sounds. I can't even pinpoint what instrument that is. I remember someone in the comments saying what they think it might be. But you know, there's this weird sort of tangy sound, jazzy groove to it, which is so gorgeous. And then they have, I assume, the edited vocals layering the melody. Ooh, ah, ooh, ooh, ah. And I think that's gorgeous. And then we launch into these mellow verses from Namjoon, followed by, I think it's J-Hope, then Suga. And J-Hope and Suga, they just sort of seamless... No, it's Suga, then J-Hope. I think it's that way around. They just seamlessly flow into each other, those two. Their voices are reasonably similar. It's quite easy to tell who's who, but the way they just sort of flow into each other, it's like in Mic Drop, where they just sort of switch over between the two of them. It's really fantastic how they can do that. But Namjoon drops just an incredible verse, and his delivery is perfect. He's got such a mellow vibe. It's so sort of lazy and smooth. It's so cool. I actually really adore how he delivers it. And then, of course, Suga and J-Hope do an incredible job as well. But Namjoon, especially on this song, I love how his voice works with the instrumental. The chorus is all right. It's not my absolute favourite chorus on the album, but given the instrumental and the verses, the rap line drop is absolutely fantastic. Now, the next track for me is probably one of the only misses on this album. I think it's a bit of a missed opportunity. This is Paradise. It's a fairly simple pop song with some decent vocals, a not very interesting chorus, and a not very interesting instrumental. I couldn't really get into it. It just... what wasn't my sound, and I thought it was just a bit bland, and the melody just wasn't really there. I was hoping for some more powerful vocals, but they sort of stay at this same middling tone, and I just didn't really all that much enjoy it. I thought it was a bit bland, and especially given where it sits between two of my favourite songs on this album, it's incredibly forgettable. So yeah, I don't want to dwell on that for too long, because I just think it's a bit of a missed opportunity. It's just a bit bland. The next track is Love Maze. My lord, this is a great track. The vocals on this are so breathy. They're so fantastic. The production, though, this is the height of BTS's production. Obviously, the rap line all had a role in producing most of this album, Namjoon on all the songs. But I think credit has to also be given to P-Dog and Hitman, because they do a great job throughout this album. They're constantly creative, constantly concocting new ideas, and they also do this great electronic sound that not many producers can do in a way that's original, because they often tracks are just sort of blend together. Here, it's such a fun, inventive sound. Namjoon does a great job once again delivering a fantastic verse. I love his voice here. Compare that to the Pluto track, where he was doing this really slow, lazy delivery, which was, you know, really, really cool. Here, it's all boisterous and aggressive and loud and confident. How he changes like that and can, you know, deliver an as good verse is unbelievable to me, and it just shows the versatility that he has as a rapper, and he's absolutely fantastic. The chorus on this is actually pretty goddamn good. I do really enjoy that. Overall, this track, I enjoy it a lot. With Pluto, Fake Love, Singularity, it's just a lot of good songs during this first half. The seventh track on this album is Magic Shop, a really intense, again, electronic sounding track. That hook chorus, I'm still not keen on. When I did the first listen, I thought it might be growing on me, but really, it's just a little bit obnoxious. It's just so intense and mechanical sounding. As much as I enjoy the vocal delivery by the vocal line, it's just not a very attractive chorus. Not chorus, a hook. The sounds are just not enjoyable to me. Even though the rest of the track is really decent, the production's nice, the vocals are nice. I especially like those sort of that tingly melody section at the beginning. I think it's some sort of woodwind where it goes like, woo! I really enjoy that, especially V's delivery paired with that. And it's such sort of like a bare and open instrumental. That works incredibly well, but I just can't get past that chorus. And for me, it makes for a little bit of difficult listening, because I just don't enjoy it as much, especially given that Love Maze is right before it, which is such an easy, comfortable, fun listen. And the next track is Despacito Part 2. Airplane Part 2. I'm sure that joke's been made before. This is BTS's attempt at Latin pop. Does it work? Yes and no. I really do enjoy the inventive instrumental that they went for. Yes, there are a lot of Latin sounds that are mixed in there, but overall it stays true to the BTS sound. The drums are fantastic. And I do enjoy sections, but that goddamn chorus, it's just not what I want. This song is essentially talking about how successful BTS have now been, that they're going all over the world. But that chorus, you know, oh, we've been to Milan, we're going to London, to Brazil. For me, it's just not enjoyable at all. It's not fun. The vocals aren't even that good. And I was a little bit disappointed with that on re-listens. But I do love how inventive the instrumental is, how fun and vibrant the verses are. And J-Hope uses a verse from Airplane Part 1, which was part of his solo mixtape. And he uses that verse and moves it over here. And I thought that was really clever. And it works incredibly well. I haven't actually checked. I assume Airplane Part 1 and Part 2 have the same BPM. If they don't, that's even more impressive that he switched it over into a completely different style and delivered it with as much aplomb as before. Because it works incredibly, incredibly well. And he is the highlight on this song for me. So yeah, I did enjoy Airplane Part 2. The drums were great, but I just couldn't really enjoy that chorus. And I think that's something that just keeps on coming up, because Magic Shop, I didn't enjoy the chorus. Paradise, I didn't enjoy the chorus. And on another track later on, I just don't enjoy the chorus. The next track is probably one of the most interesting tracks on this album. I'm not sure whether I like it, but I find it quite funny. It's BTS's attempt at sort of this trap sounding vocal R&B pop mix. And I'm saying all those different genres because it really does feel like that. At the beginning, we have these really open, weird vocals that have been edited to death. I think it's by V. Taeyong. To me, it sounds like something off a Lil Yachty album. Where for you, vampire man? And it's so spacious and weird. I don't really know where that delivery's come from, but it was a lot of fun. And the rest of the track sort of follows in suit. The chorus is all about Anpan Man, who is a superhero who's not very good, and something like that. And it's about wanting to be Anpan Man, but like, you know, doing good deeds. That's what I could gather from the lyrics. I might have that a little bit wrong, because I haven't read the lyrics for Anpan Man since I first did my like read through. But I did enjoy it overall. The instrumental is fairly creative, if a little bit uninteresting and bland. It's a fairly regular R&B pop mix for the rest of the song. There's only really these trap soundings, the bits at the beginning, which are interesting. They are definitely interesting. That's the thing. I enjoy the beginning part of this song, but the rest of it, like, oh, da 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 da, and bam, man. I don't know quite what they're going for. And given that it's placed after Part 2 and Airplane in the next song, it just feels a little bit strange on re-listens. I really enjoyed it during the first listen, and I'm actually looking forward to seeing this live a lot. I feel like this could be a very fun song live, just like 21st Century Girl, Bapsai, and all that. And now we have So What, along with Paradise, probably the only other song I can say I don't really like. The hook is so intense and blary. It's better than, what is it, the Love Maze? No. Magic Shop. It's Magic Shop. It's better than the Magic Shop chorus, which is just so mechanical sounding. But here, I'm just really sick to death of BTS doing these intense hip-hop electronic sounds. And this is the sort of song they would usually put as their title track. I'm glad they didn't, but I'm just a little bit sick to death of them doing it. And I feel like they've nailed it so much so that this isn't a bad song by any stretch. I just cannot enjoy it. And it's a reoccurring thing that I just want to skip it, because it's just not very interesting to me anymore. They've overdone it. So that is what it is. So what? Doesn't really mean anything. Yeah, but I actually did think that the lyrics on it were rather nice. One of the better tracks in terms of that. But finally, we have another amazing track. The outro tier. This is the best outro since House of Cards. I enjoyed the Wings outro. I enjoyed the Love Yourself Her outro. They were both fine, decent tracks. This one, wow, this is almost Cypher levels for BTS in terms of how heavy it is on the rap line. And I love the verse Namjoon's bits. This is the most emotional, intense and passionate he's been in a while. And he's really given himself freedom to go for a completely different flow. And I love how he does it. It's so intense. The chorus is great. Suga and J-Hope also deliver really emotive, passionate verses. And it's got so much heavy reverb on it, this track. I love that they've gone for that because they don't usually go for tracks sounding like that. And it's a lot of fun. There's some decent vocals. I think it's from Jin at the end, or just before J-Hope's verse. He delivers these sort of mechanical sounding vocals, but they're a lot of fun, actually. I know mechanical, because I often use that as an insult, but it's insult, a criticism. but it's not here. It sounds really, really nice how they've layered it in and put it together. And that's something I do want to touch on. This has been an incredibly long review, but the instrumentals were pretty much all phenomenal. I didn't really like the Paradise, and then I'm a little bit sick to death of the production on things like So What, and I always get confused between Love Maze and Magic Shop, but... overall, this is so well produced. So many good vocal parts, so many good rap line performances. Overall, this album is next to Wings as my favourite. Maybe a little bit under, but it could grow on me. Of course, HYYH Part 2 is also another favourite of mine, but I think in terms of creativity, fun, and forgetting about nostalgia, because that is the first BTS comeback, really, that happened whilst I've been a fan. The part two for HYYH. This would probably be my second favourite BTS project. So, yeah, goddamn, that's kind of crazy to think about. Anyway, yeah, what would I give this as a rating? I've sort of deliberated over this because I often give albums really, really high ratings. Given I gave the VIX project, I think it was a 9 out of 10. Did I enjoy this as much as that project? Yeah. Critically, would I say it's as good as that? Yeah, I would. So I think I'm going to give this a 9 out of 10. Maybe on the lower side of a 9 out of 10. I'm quite liberal with my ratings. They're not really super intensely classified. I really enjoyed this project. It's not perfect, so it's not going to get a 10 out of 10. So yeah, for me, I guess... it's a 9 out of 10. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and a comment suggestion for someone to watch in the future. This is going to be Gino signing out. See you guys soon. Got a bad little mama and she always with the shits. Put 100 in my pocket and 100 on the rims. That's my little bitch. That's my little bitch. That's my little bitch. That's my little bitch. Put a red dress on her and some gas for the trip. Got 100 in my pocket and a couple on the tent. That's my little bitch. That's my little bitch. That's my little bitch.